Scotland in 1825, Robert Dunsmuir made his fortune mining coal on Vancouver Island. And the BC Archives has a file brimming with documents connected to the original mine application. And Veronica Cooper has that story.
I had the honor to apply for a prospecting license for coals on the land adjoining Departure Bay near Nanaimo.
This file is filled with fascinating papers and maps from the 1870s.
And the file is the original application of Robert Dunsmuir for his mine, the coal mine that led to all of his fortune.
The application was approved December 4, 1869, and it's a fascinating file to look through 150 years later.
And the claim is in the area of Long Lake and Diver Lake. The coal mine was landlocked. He had to get it to Departure Bay, but there were other settlers in that area, so he asked for a right-of-way through William Hughes's property. And, of course, he got to Departure Bay where he built a wharf, and that's where the coal was shipped off to market. He's got the list of money, all of the expenditures in the first year, and so he paid about $6,600 in order to hire staff to prospect there, and he only made $1,100 for selling the coal to others. So it was a losing proposition at first, but by 1878, this mine was the largest producing mine in British Columbia.
The file came to the BC Archives from a government records warehouse on Herald Street in Victoria.
It was a warehouse that the government cleaned out in the late 70s, early 80s, and the files in there included a lot of records from Lands Department. And we were processing some records from that came from the warehouse, and I came across this file.
A file that has now been digitally scanned for the public and researchers to view anytime online.
This Week in History, brought to you by the Royal BC Museum, bringing British Columbia's stories together.